known as Saudi Arabia.
Okay. So Saudi the Sunni Arabia, religion is not from the Sunni religion the is not the Islam.
The real Sunni religion that was at the
there isn't a Sunni religion. There is Islam. Islam. Yeah, Islam. There is Islam. There is no Sunni religion.
Wait, so you're not saying you're not Sunni? Are you Sunni?
It's not a religion.
But are you Sunni? You have to clarify yourself.
I am a Muslim.
No, but everyone says a Muslim. Shia said a Muslim.
Yeah, but so. No, listen.
So what Muslim are you?
I am a Sunni. What does it mean a Sunni?
So after Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, okay, the people probably used to call themselves a Sunni. But Ahmadis are the real original Sunnis.
Okay.
We are the real Muslims.
Okay, you are the real. All right. Akhi, leave him to me. Muhammad, you finished? Can I talk now? Can I talk? First of all, you said that tawaffa means death. Yeah? Okay. I'm gonna prove to you that tawaffa does not mean death. From the Quran.
Okay, but
Muhammad, don't let me talk. I've left you talk. You see, are we gonna have a civilized conversation or are we gonna? Okay. For example, get the verse so that he can see it. Go to Surah An-Nisa, chapter 4, verse 15. Go to it. And read it.
And those of you whom you are guilty of lewdness, call to witness four of you against them, and if they bear witness, then confine them to their houses until death overtakes them. Until death overtakes them.
Okay, what does it say in Arabic? Hatta yatawaffahunna al-maut. So tawaffa also means take. Because in here tawaffa, it means please do not film him. Yeah, not him. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So tawaffa, it means take. In here, in this verse in Quran, like in Surah Al-An'am, هو الذي يتوفاكم بالليل ويعلم ما جرحتم بالنهار. يوفى إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. الله يتوفى زمر. الله يتوفى الأنفس حين موتها والتي لم تمت في منامها.
So what Allah is saying is that he's taking Jesus as in taking his soul.
Look, I'm gonna explain it to you in Arabic.
Allah took Jesus' soul to himself.
Okay.
His body is still remains.
Okay. Muhammad, just listen to me.
Because Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also died.
Muhammad.
You cannot say that Jesus went up alive.
Muhammad. Is Allah
the highest stating of Jesus?
Is Allah all powerful or not?
Of course.
Is Allah all powerful?
But Allah has laws. He has certain rules. He's not going to change his nature.
So if Allah, when somebody dies, when, are you saying to
what
me?
His nature from the Quran?
No. Are you telling me? Are you telling me that when somebody? Listen to me. Are you saying when somebody dies, they won't come back to life in this life? Is that what you're saying?
Yes, in this life.
Okay. What about in Surah Al-Baqarah? Allah Jalla wa Ala says about Uzair, the story of Uzair, فَأَمَاتَهُ اللَّهُ مِئَةَ عَامٍ ثُمَّ بَعَثَهُ.
أصحاب الكهف.
No, Ashab al-Kahf, they were asleep. Leave Ashab al-Kahf.
There's another Quranic verse where it says, when someone dies, it's impossible for them to return.
Listen, فَأَمَاتَهُ اللَّهُ. Read it, فَأَمَاتَهُ اللَّهُ.
Yeah, Uzair, and his donkey as well, yeah.
It's in the 200s.
Yeah, something in Surah Al-Baqarah, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. It's in 200s. So what do you say about وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ.
Yeah, what happened was Jesus, he was on the cross. When he was on the cross, the Jews, they tried to kill him. But
okay.
Allah saved him.
Okay.
Allah saved him and he came off the cross.
You know, in Arabic.
Allah saved
him. Are you listening?
He came off the cross.
Are you listening, Muhammad? Muhammad.
Everything's
Muhammad. Let's Muhammad, ما in Arabic. Ma. This ma is ma nafiya. It negates. You know what it means, Muhammad? It negates. It's saying wa ma salabuh. They did not crucify him. It negates. You know what negates? Do you know what negates in English? Okay. So wa ma salabuh, it means they did not crucify him.
Yes.
They did not kill him. So you can't say he was crucified when Allah.
You're not saying he's crucified.
You just say to me.
Please,
brothers, respect him. Respect him, please.
I said Jesus, he did not die on the cross. He was not crucified on the cross.
No, but if you say crucified, when you get crucified, you don't die for sure.
Yes, but Jesus was put on the cross.
Listen to me.
Saved him.
There are people now. People every what we call it in April. The Christians do it. Easter, Jazakallah khair. Every Easter, you'll see that Christians they put them on the cross, and some of them in Philippines, I've seen them. They put nails through their hands, I've listened to you. Why you don't listen to me?
No, I agree with you.
Okay, so they. No, I didn't say Jesus. I'm talking about someone in the Philippines.
Yeah, but I'm talking about Jesus.
Are you? Jesus. Muhammad, are we going to talk or no?
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. So, they put the nails in their hands and they crucify them, but they don't die. Now, what I'm telling you, what you're saying, Allah Jalla wa Ala is saying they did not crucify him. Forget about the death. They did not put him on the cross.
No, he was put on the cross.
So am I gonna believe Allah or believe you?
I believe Allah. Allah's the one who's saying it.
Allah saying wa ma yes. Muhammad ma yes. Negates.
Yes.
Ma negates when the crucifixion.
Say, why does the Bible say that he did not die?
Muhammad, are we talking about Quran? Are you a Christian? Am I talking to a Christian?
No, you're speaking to a Muslim.
No, to a Qadiani I'm talking. Because Muslims don't say this. No, look, no Muslim would say that Isa alayhi salam was crucified.
Muhammad alayhi salam said that he was not crucified.
You know, Razi? Let me tell you one thing.
Razi, I don't want to speak about
people. No. Let me just tell you what he says. Well, he's the same. He's one of your scholars. He says that Ibn Hazm says that Isa is dead. Yeah? But listen, Ibn Hazm that Razi uses says, whoever says that Isa ibn Maryam was crucified or killed is a kafir, his blood is allowed and his money is allowed. Now you choose, because your scholar, Razi, says that. So
this.
Now you're saying that he's crucified, that he was crucified?
Let me ask you again.
According to Ibn Hazm, you're a kafir.
Did I once say that Jesus was crucified on the cross?
You just said it.
No, I didn't. You're making up stuff.
Did I hear wrong? So he wasn't crucified.
You know my belief more than me.
He wasn't crucified. Was he crucified or not?
No, Jesus was not crucified.
You just said that, Muhammad.
I'm telling you he was not crucified.
Okay. So he wasn't crucified,
You have to understand.
Okay, Muhammad. He wasn't crucified. All right. He wasn't crucified.
That's what I told you.
He wasn't crucified.
Yes, he was not
crucified. So if he wasn't crucified and he wasn't killed, How would he die? How would he have died?
So what happened was, as I told you, Jesus, he did not die on the cross, but he suffered later on a natural death.
Muhammad, you realize what you're saying? You just said now that he was crucified. You just said that he was crucified now.
He came off the cross.
Muhammad.
Jesus came off the cross.
You know what's crucified? Crucified, it doesn't mean death. Crucified, it means put on the cross.
Yes, he was put on the cross, exactly.
But Allah Jalla wa Ala said he was not crucified.
He did not die on the cross.
We don't talk about death, Muhammad. We talk, look, Muhammad.
Jesus was put on the cross.
Muhammad,
he did not die on the cross.
Muhammad.
This is why
Muhammad.
He came off the cross.
Get your own translation.
Iran.
I want to see your own translation.
Iran.
Get me your own translation.
And then he came to India.
Get me your own translation.
And India is where he died.
Get me your own translation.
Of what?
Of the verse. وَمَا قَتَلُهُ وَمَا صَلَبُهُ. Get me your own translation. Because even your own translation doesn't say that.
You translate in Google. That's why you get confused.
It's in Surah Nisa. Yeah. وما قتلوه وما صلبوه.
ولكن شو بيعلم.
Get it for, yeah. Yeah. Just to write وما قتلوه وما صلبوه, yeah. It's gonna come to you. Sorry, شكرا.
Well, look, even the situation in Palestine as well.
So listen. We'll talk about Palestine in a bit. No, I need. I will talk about Palestine. But let's talk. Read that to me in English, according to your own translation. According to your own translation. Yeah, we'll talk about Palestine. I promise you, we'll talk about Palestine.
They need to accept the Messiah. Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Muhammad.
Who?
Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Muhammad, they have to accept the Messiah.
Okay. No, just so listen to me, Muhammad is,
you can run away from the truth.
Oh, okay, I'm not gonna run away. Is a prophet, can he be a liar?
Prophet is not a liar.
Can a prophet side with the oppressors? Can a prophet side with the oppressors?
No.
He can't. Mirza Ghulam, was he siding with the British Raj or not? Was he siding with the British Raj or
Islam
not?
Islam was attacked by the people that were living in India.
Who? Which people?
There were people, the people that oppressed.
I'm talking
Islam.
About the British Raj. The British Raj.
I'm talking about the British Raj. Yeah, I'm speaking about it.
Yeah, the British Raj.
So what happened was, with the British said, what they're going to do is, they told these people to don't break down mosques. They said, do not attack people because of the religion.
Are the British non-Muslims or not?
The British Raj. Protect the mosques.
Victoria, was she a Muslim?
Victoria was a Muslim.
What, Victoria, was she a Muslim?
Why a prophet would go
to an oppressor? Someone who's killing his own people.
In Pakistan, they're breaking down mosques.
Okay.
Innocent people.
Do you know? Listen to me.
He's not addressing the question.
They're not letting people worship or even pray five times
a day. Okay. Wait.
This is in Pakistan.
Well, wait. So you finished? Or are you gonna start talking all? Are you gonna?
I'm telling you, in Pakistan, what they do is they attack.
Are you gonna allow me to talk, Muhammad?
They attack people just because of
their beliefs. Muhammad. Okay.
If someone says that they're Muslims, how can you go and attack them and start breaking down the mosques?
Okay.
How can you go and kill innocent children?
Okay, you finished?
Mothers.
You finished?
Women, for no reason.
You finished,
just
Muhammad?
Of belief.
Muhammad, you finished?
This was the same.
Okay, Muhammad, I'll wait.
Used to happen at the time of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi
Wasallam. Are you preaching?
No, I'm telling you what's happening.
Okay, you finished?
I'm telling you that state of the Muslim world is not good because they're all divided.
Okay.
Why is it that Saudi Arabia are not protecting the...
No, have you finished? Why your Khalifa is not protecting? Why your Khalifa is not protecting? Why Masrur is not protecting the Muslims? Where? Why? By spying on the Muslims?
He said to the people of Palestine, look, accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and accept His second coming. He's a Messiah and the Khalifa of this time.
So they have to accept in order, you know. Well, but we had the Quran before your Messiah came.
The Quran.
We had it before.
The Quran, the real teaching of the Quran.
According to your imposter.
Alayhi
min Allah ma yastahiq.
The translation that you're getting is from the Sunnis. From Saudi Arabia.
So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what was he? What was the Prophet? Okay, now you finished.
What I'm trying to tell you is that the translation is corrupt.
Muhammad, look, I'm diabetic and you're putting my diabetes so high.
Because this is what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam
prophesied. Muhammad, I've been nice to you. Muhammad, have I been nice to you or not? Okay, now are you going to listen to what I'm going to say or not? But you've been talking non-stop.
Let's have a dialogue, not a monologue.
At the later times, there will be Dijal.
Muhammad.
It's all here.
Muhammad, you finished? Look, you know the second Khalif. The second Khalif,
yes.
Bashir Ahmed.
He was a sign.
Okay. But you know him.
Yes.
You admit that he's your second Khalif. Okay. You know your magazine called Al-Fadl?
Al-Fadl, yes.
Okay. You know Al-Fadl number 22, yeah? number 22. It was released on the 7th of December, 1918. You know what your second Khalif did say? He said, they tell us, meaning the Muslims, in India at the time, they tell us, why do you rejoice from the defeat, from the victories of the British Raj? He answers, he goes, why shall we not rejoice? Why shall we not rejoice for the Mahdi? Meaning, who is the Mahdi? The Mahdi is Mirza Ghulam Ahmed. Yes. He is also the Mahdi. For the Mahdi, listen to me. For the Mahdi said, I am the Mahdi and the British government is my sword. This is his sword. Now, this is a prophet of Allah that does not seek. I just told you, Al-Fadl 22, 7th of December, 1918. What more do you want?
I don't know this topic. I don't know what you're saying.
You don't know what I'm saying? Suddenly you don't know. Who is Bashir Ahmed? Who is Bashir Ahmed? Mirza Bashir Ahmed?
No, I agree.
Okay, stop. Al-Fadl, is it your magazine or not?
Yes, it's a magazine.
22, 1918.
I have not seen it.
Okay.
I'm telling you.
You're
more than me, yeah.
Well, take it then. He said that the Mahdi, he said, I am the Mahdi, and the British government is my sword. So sword on who? On the Muslims. And he said, and he went on to say, and remember, Mirza Ghulam used to tell the Muslims, he used to say to the Muslims, because the British Raj got really beaten up from the Muslims, especially in 1857, in the War of Independence. They call it the Great Mutiny, they call it different names, but it was for the independence of India. So he used to tell the Muslims, do not fight the British. Why? Because they are a good people. They have done this to us, and so on. However,
never said fight anyone.
That's what I mean.
Azim is the Ghulam Ahmed only said.
That's what I mean.
Only said if you do jihad through the pen.
That's what I mean. So
he always said through the pen.
Okay, is he a Dili? Why is he? What?
No.
Is he a follower of Muhammad or is he more higher than Muhammad?
No, he's following Muhammad.
He's following Muhammad.
He said, I'm a servant.
Okay. Did he come with the new legislation or
he
no?
No, nothing new.
Nothing. So why would he say stop jihad when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did jihad until he died?
Yeah, we still doing jihad.
Which jihad?
Jihad as in the free pen.
Did Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam do the jihad of teaching or the jihad of sword?
This is a different timings.
What timing? Jihad is until the day of judgment.
Exactly. So what does jihad mean? Jihad means to strive.
There are so many different... Look. There is the jihad.
Jihad does not mean...
There is the jihad. Listen.
People. That's not jihad.
Okay. Okay. Did the Qadianis kill people in Iraq and in Syria or
no? We don't kill no one.
Okay. How about Al-Fadl? Al-Fadl again, number 31. Listen, Al-Fadl, number 31.
We are a peaceful movement.
Okay, peaceful movement.
Same movement that we brought out for.
Okay. So listen, people. Al-Fadl magazine, which is their magazine, August. 1923, Bashir Ahmed. I'm not making stuff. Bashir Ahmed. Listen, you look it up. And if I'm a liar, you come in front of all these people and you tell me a liar. So this is Bashir Fadl. Listen, Al-Fadl, August 1923. He said that we have sent Qadianis to Iraq to share blood with who? Not with the Muslims, but with the British Raj against the Muslims. Is this a prophet?
Bro,
is this a prophet?
Okay, let me tell you. Azam Mirza Ghulam Ahmed never said to attack any Muslims.
لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. I've just told you.
Nowhere did Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmed, may Allah be pleased with him, ever say to attack or kill anyone. Never.
Am I a kafir for you or not? Am I a kafir for you or not?
No, you're not kafir.
I'm not a kafir. Then you're not Qadiani. You're not Qadiani. Wallahi, listen. You either a Qadiani. You either are a Qadiani. I'm a Qadiani. Look.
Qadiani, as you say, Qadian is a peaceful movement.
Okay.
It loves and respects
a peaceful movement with non-Muslims. But with Muslims, no way.
So why is in Pakistan, where you have given us land, we are peaceful?
Listen.
Why is that?
Listen, I'm telling you. No, me, according to Mirza Ghulam Ahmed.
Retaliate.
You know Tadkira? You know Tadkira?
You never retaliate.
Khazair Rouhani? Tadkira? Tadkira? Yeah? Tadkira? Okay, Tadkira. Mirza Ghulam says in Tadkira, he says, they, meaning the Muslims, are kafir, do not marry of them, or...
Why are you talking about marriage? Marriage is a different topic.
He's telling you what Mirza Ghulam says.
Do not marry of them, do not even pray janaza on them. That's what your imposter said about the Muslims.
Why do we say at the time when there was a coffin that was being taken, Muhammad SAW stood up for it? All the people around him, they did not stood up because they said this is
Muhammad,
the
Muhammad,
of the Jews.
Muhammad.
Muhammad SAW said no.
That's your imposter. Your imposter saying about us that we are kafir.
No. You believe that we are kafir.
You are kafir. Of course you are a kafir. You are a kafir. You believe that someone came after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you're a kafir.
You believe the same thing.
What?
Is Jesus alive?
Yes, he is alive.
He's not going to come back.
He is going to come back.
He's going
to
be a prophet.
No, but wait. Can I answer him? Let me answer him. Once you are a prophet, you're always a prophet.
There you go. Same thing as Jesus.
That's what you just
said. Subhanallah. Listen to me.
Muhammad.
Muhammad.
It's going to be the same Quran.
Muhammad.
The same thing as us.
Muhammad. I'm a teacher. Muhammad. Muhammad. I'm a teacher of jurisprudence. Okay? Muhammad.
For the people that taught you.
Muhammad.
I've heard so many people that speak to that.
Muhammad. Muhammad.
No.
I want to give you an example.
I want to give you an example.
Muhammad, you are not learned. That's why I'm just. You see, the problem is you're not learned. So that's the problem I have got with you. That's the problem
that
I have. Yeah, that's what I mean.
And
it's a problem. It's a problem.
The second coming, according to all the prophecies.
Listen to me. I'm going to ask you to come to the real deen, the deen of Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, not of that imposter. You know what he said? You know what he said about the wife of his own brother? A prostitute. I know. Tadkira. Go to Tadkira. Khazair Rouhani. Khazair Rouhani.
If you make this kind of allegation, you have to bring the mark. You have to bring the mark from the original sources.
Just wait. You want me to give? I'll give. No problem.
Wait, brother. Wait. Just take your time. I know it's hurting.
Muhammad.
It's hurting.
Muhammad.
Digest a lot of things, you know.
No, I just said he's
definitely stressed. No, he's been fair with you. He's explaining something to you.
Listen, Muhammad. Wait. I'm gonna give you some nice things. That what your prophet said, yeah?
Bro, you're making up stuff, man.
Wallahi al-Azim, I'm going to give you the references. Muhammad. Muhammad, I will not. Look at me. Muhammad, you are young enough. Muhammad. Muhammad, you are young enough to be my child. Muhammad.
You see the people.
Muhammad, I am like your father. Muhammad.
Saudi Arabia, they understand.
Muhammad, watch this. Muhammad, read this. Read this, Muhammad. Read it.
But this is Urdu.
No. Okay, but read it. What does it say? Tadkira. It says Tadkira. I'm going to read it to you. Listen to me, Muhammad. It's from the original. It's a scan, Muhammad. It's a scan. A scan. Muhammad, it's the Tadkira. Muhammad, it's Tadkira. And it is.
Give us a reference.
Kitab al-Wahi al-Qadiani. The revelation. Qadiani revelation. التذكرة page 399 okay and you say يريدون أن يروا طمثك. They want to see your menses. Now he talking about himself. This is a revelation from Yalash, because for his God is Yalash. It's not Allah. He has Allah. Given. Listen, not according to Mirza Ghulam. Not according to Mirza. Not according to Mirza Ghulam. That's Allah. The problem. You see the Allah problem with you people. Allah you do not know your books.
Allah.
You
Allah
do not know your books.
Stop deceiving.
Wallahi, I'm not deceiving. By Allah, the Dajjal is your... Okay, 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 okay. Now look, 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 reference in here. Muhammad, 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 your book, not me, your book.
Let's speak about Palestine. Let's speak about Palestine.
Muhammad, your book.
Let's speak about Palestine.
Okay, okay, but your book, he says, it says, Muhammad, Muhammad, it says, they want, this is your prophet, your prophet, your prophet.
Why is Bangladesh not condemning now the
time? Listen, listen to you.
Your prophet, your prophet.
Have some good manner, listen to it.
Did Masrur, condemn it? Did Masrur condemn it? No, he didn't. He sided with the Jews. He sided with the Jews.
Masrur Ahmed said, pray for these people.
Wallahi, he sided with the Jews. And he said, unless if you want this problem to be solved, believe in Mirza Ghulam. Did he say that or not? Did he say that or not? Did he say that or not?
Yes, you have to believe in it.
So that and then the problem will stop. The problem will stop once you believe in Mirza Ghulam. That means come from Islam, come out from Islam, stop believing in jihad, in fighting for your own rights, and then of course everything will be alright.
Ahmadiyya is Islam.
Listen to me.
This is a regional Islam.
He, your prophet, your prophet says, your prophet says that he's got menses. Menses! You know it's menses? Period. Women's stuff. Wallahi, I'm not making it. This is in his book, At-Tadhkira. At-Tadhkira. Anybody that knows to read Arabic? Anybody? Anybody that reads Arabic? Anybody that reads Arabic? If you don't believe me, anybody that reads Arabic? At-Tadhkira. Listen, At-Tadhkira. He says,
if the Sunni world are divided,
brother, read Sira,
why don't they unite?
Okay, okay.
And say to Israel, what are you doing against Palestine? Why don't they stick up for Palestine?
Look, we've got ladies in here.
Don't change your topic.
Okay, okay. خلي خلي.
Why is Bangla not there?
Muhammad, 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 Muhammad. We've got ladies in here. Otherwise, I'm gonna tell you what your prophet said.
I am telling you. Shadrin,
but we've got ladies in here.
Hazam is Ghulam Ahmad. I mean, Hazam is Masrur Ahmad. They say you come united as one, and it's best to come united under the Caliphate.
Do you know that you're? Do you
if
know?
You come under united under the.
Do you know that you're? Do you know that you're imposter? Do you know that your imposter said that he's Maryam? Do you know that he said that he's Maryam? Wallahi, I'm not making it. It's in Tadhkira.
He's born here, so he's not aware of that. You need to read
make up more new stuff.
Wallahi, look, it's in a Tadhkira. It's in a Tadhkira. Okay. It's in a Tadhkira. Listen, Muhammad, 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 I'm not lying to you. I'm not lying to you. Muhammad, Muhammad, don't get upset. Don't get upset. Muhammad, come, come. Wallahi, come, come. Wallahi, come, Muhammad, Muhammad. I want you, look, Muhammad, I want the good for you. Wallahi, I want you, I don't want you to be in Jahannam. Wallahi al-Azim, Aqsimu billah, I don't want you to go to the hellfire. I want you to come to the true Islam.
How do you know who's going to hell and who's not going to hell?
And now a kafir is going to hell. A kafir is going to hell.
Let Allah choose.
Allah says it. Okay, Allah says it.
Okay, that's fine. But let Allah choose.
Muhammad.
Let Allah make the fool.
Muhammad, if you do not believe, if you believe that there is a prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and that he receives a revelation and that he's got tashri' and legislation, then you are going to the hellfire, Muhammad.
Who said?
Allah Jalla wa Ala says.
Show me. Show me.
Muhammad, do you read Quran? Do you read Quran, Muhammad?
Show me from the Quran, show me from the hadith.
Inna alladhina kafaru.
Show me where does it say that after Muhammad
min ahli al-kitabi wal-mushrikeen. You are a mushrik.
Show me.
Fi nari jahannama khalidina fiha.
What is the verse? Show me the verse.
Muhammad, go to Juz Amma. Go to Juz Amma.
No, it's the Quran, yeah?
Yeah, it's Quran, subhanAllah. It's wahi, it's a revelation. I've just received a revelation. You know, I'm the Mahdi.
What surah?
No, astaghfirullah.
What surah?
يا أخي إيش؟ أنا حسني، أنا حسني المهدي من الحسنيين. خلاص أنا إذا قال هو نبي ما أقول أنا أنا مهدي. ها؟ العصا هذه لمن يعصى؟ لمن يعصى؟ go to سورة let me get it for you. سبحان الله. والله my you know my diabetes is sky high with you. All right, listen. But before we go to that, let me give you this. التذكرة. The Kitab al-Wahy al-Qadiani. Wallahi. No, listen, this is very important. Wallahi, this is very important. Kitab al-Wahy al-Qadiani. Tadkira 71. Now, Tadkira is their book. And you know what? There is more than 1,000, yeah? A Tadkira. I'm not running away. I'm here, Muhammad. I'm here. He says, he says, there is a verse in Surah Maryam. In Surah Maryam, there is a verse. In Surah Maryam. Listen, Muhammad, in Surah...
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ Yeah.
بارك الله فيك. الله يجزيك الخير.
Those who disbelieve, yeah?
Surah 98.
So you choose. Either you're a kafir or you're a mushrik. But it doesn't... Wherever you go, you're in. That's the problem.
Number six.
We just want good for you. We have no problem with you, Muhammad.
Number six or seven.
I have a problem. Listen, Muhammad.
Huh? Surah 98.
Yeah, which verse?
Verse six.
Verily, those who disbelieve from among the
people.
What
is belief? What is belief?
Yeah, accept.
No, let him finish. From amongst the Jews and the Christians, yeah? And the mushriks. And the mushriks.
In fire of the hell, abiding therein. They are the worst of creatures.
Okay.
So where does it say, if you believe in a prophet after Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you are a kafir? Where does it say that?
La ilaha illallah.
No, where does it say
that? Surah Al-Ahzab. Surah Al-Ahzab. You know, I'll give you a so. وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِ Look, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ What do you say Islam Ahmadiyya or no?
I'm asking you.
Do you say, okay, do you say Islam Ahmadiyya or you say Islam? So, this Allah Jalla wa'ala in Quran says, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ إِسْلَامِ الْأَحْمَدِيَّةِ فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ Or did he say Islam?
This is Islam, Ahmadiyya is this
Meaning you attribute Islam to Ahmed, Masiha. To Ahmed.
To Masiha.
Yeah, you attribute Islam to him.
Which goes back to Islam of Which Muhammad Islam?
But the Islam of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لا نبي بعدي, لا نبي بعدي. أنا خاتم النبيين.
Yes, there's no new
لا نبي بعدي.
There's no new prophet, no new Sharia, no new Quran.
Okay. Did he used to give zakah?
Yes, zakat. Yes.
He.
Yes.
لا إله إلا الله. He said that he never gave zakah himself. Okay. Let me give you this. The prophets.
You're talking about worse.
The prophets.
About the people.
The prophets.
And the
prophets. The prophets. The prophets. Leave him. The prophets. When they die and they leave some money, do people inherit it or do they give it as sadaqah?
So,
I asked you a question.
So, the Jamaat.
No, the Jamaat. Prophets.
We talked about prophets at the time of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
If you talk about what there was only one prophet at the time, which is Muhammad.
Yeah. All the prophets and before him. Prophets.
Mm-hmm.
When Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
Uh huh.
Okay. He used to have wealth.
You're making yourself look bad, Muhammad.
His wealth was used for the Ummah.
Muhammad.
The Ummah at that time.
Muhammad.
Was Muhammad
when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam died, he had a piece of land.
Yes, and land.
Yeah. Fadak.
Yes.
In Fadak. Yeah.
For what?
For the Ummah. When Mirza Ghulam died, where did his money go to?
Towards the Jamaat.
Towards the Jamaat.
Towards the
no, it went towards his children.
Yeah, who are who was the khalifa?
But it shouldn't go to him.
Why? He's a khalifa.
It doesn't matter.
He's the biggest person.
It doesn't matter. But he's his son. He inherited.
Yes, because that's the khalifa.
Okay, why did he need to go? No, he wasn't the khalifa straight
he's
after.
The khalifa.
Nuruddin al-Hakim was.
Yeah, yeah.
Who was the first khalifa?
Yes,
why did the money didn't go to Nuruddin al-Hakim?
Yes, it went to him as well.
It didn't go to him. He's not his child.
He's a khalifa. He's gonna go to
the money went to his children.
Yes, then afterwards when he went to his children because he became the khalifa.
It's not that he went after. When he died, the money, they even fought about it. Why did his first children, you know his first children, the two children from his wife?
Yes.
For his first wife for 40 years.
Yes.
The ones that disbelieved in him.
No.
They don't believe in him that he's a prophet. You know why?
No.
Do you know why?
No.
Shall I tell you why?
No.
Yeah, you don't know. You know when you know Muhammad Begum, Muhammad Begum, the one that he said he received the revelation.
There was two.
Muhammad Begum.
There was two revelations.
Okay, tell me the revelations. Did he marry her?
It was said that if he does not marry her,
uh-huh.
the father will die.
No. There was two revelations.
The father died.
Okay, and
so
the other revelation. And the other revelation. What did he say about her husband? What did he say about her husband?
I don't know about his husband.
So you choose to not know?
I know about the
father. Well, let me tell you what he said about her husband.
Yes,
he said
believe.
In a revelation.
That's what you believe.
I don't believe. This is your box, subhanAllah. Your box. Your box. I'm talking about your box. He said that he had received a revelation that she will come to him and he will end up marrying her and her husband will die. Now her husband's name is Sultan. Mirza Sultan. Wait. Mirza Sultan. No. Mirza Sultan. And Mirza Sultan outlived Mirza Ghulam. Mirza Ghulam died in 1908. You know, Sultan went to the First World War. And he survived the First World War, and he died in 1940 something.
Okay, let's speak about Palestine.
No, wait. In 1940 something, he died.
Palestine.
No, wait. I'll talk about Palestine.
No, you know.
I'll talk about Palestine.
Palestine.
Wait.
Let's speak.
Well, let's see about your prophet.
No, we will answer.
I'm saying he's an imposter. Defend him.
No,
see if you say something about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I would have jumped.
Okay, let's ask about Palestine.
No.
Why is it that Saudi Arabia are not protecting and condemning the attacks on Israel from Palestine? Tell me.
What did Masroor say about the Palestinians?
I told you what he said.
No.
He said, make dua
shall I bring it? Shall I bring it out for you?
You bring it out wherever you like, but I'm telling you what he
what
said.
What do you mean?
He said, make dua for them.
Shall I bring it out? What did he say?
I told you what he said.
He said, No. He will tell you. He will tell a brother. Okay, we know what they say about it. I've always.
The last prophet. The Quran, say, the Quran.
Brother, okay. I know them very well.
No, it's proof.
Listen, Muhammad, listen to me, Muhammad. Your prophet said that he will marry Muhammad Begum. He died without marrying Muhammad Begum.
Two part of the prophecies. One is that Mirza Ghulam Ahmad said that if he does not marry her, then the father will die.
And the husband.
I'm telling you. So the father died.
Muhammad,
so
you don't know your religion. That's the problem. Muhammad, you don't know your religion.
Yeah, you know more than me. Yeah,
that's the problem. That's the problem, Muhammad. That's the problem.
Everyone says that they know about their religion more than what they know.
No, Muhammad, I know about your religion more than your own missionaries. More than your own missionaries. Listen, Muhammad. What about Abdullah Atham? You know Abdullah Atham? The Christian, you know him? You know Abdullah Atham?
I've heard about it.
Oh, okay. You know the prophecy about Abdullah Atham? You know he did a debate with him for 2 weeks. Mirza Ghulam did a debate with Abdullah Atham, who was a Christian revert. He did a debate with him for 2 weeks. And guess who won? Wait, Akhi. And guess who won? You know who won? Abdullah Atham. Now two people of the followers of Mirza Ghulam. Akhi, don't distract him. No, don't distract him. Leave him for me. Muhammad, stay with me. Muhammad, Akhi, min fadlak. Barakallahu fi. Jazakallahu khair. Barakallahu fi. Muhammad, listen. Abdullah Atam destroyed Mirza Ghulam for 2 weeks. Yeah. He couldn't do anything. And guess what? Two of his followers ended up becoming Christians.
Muhammad,
they become Christian. And you know what happened? A lot of Ahmadis became Christian because he lost. And guess what he said? Yeah. He said that he had a revelation. Let me finish. Muhammad, he said he had a revelation that on the 5th of September, no, on the 10th of September, on the 10th of September, he will die after 6 months because they had the debate like early in March. He said that on the 10th of December, Abdullah Atam will die. So all the Jama'ah, they went to the masjid because the period came and this Abdullah Atam was not dying. So they went to the masajid and they saying, oh, may he die.
No.
Guess what? He didn't die. Yeah, so the time went by and he didn't die. Listen, you see, he said that he doesn't know. You see, he knows.
Yeah, he's been caught lying.
He knows. Okay, he knows. No, brother. Afghani, don't do it. Listen, I know, brother, I know. Listen, you said he's died. Did you know that Abdullah Atam?
I did not say that.
You just said he repented.
Repented.
You say he repented. You said that Abdullah Atam repented. Well, let me tell you something you don't know, probably, which you know, but you're hiding. Did you know that Abdullah Atam wrote a letter and he published it in a newspaper saying, I have not repented. I am a Christian and I'm proud of being a Christian and I will die as a Christian. And the letter was released on the 15th of September. So the prophecy was not fulfilled.
It wasn't fulfilled.
And let's go to another one. Before he died, he said that he had a revelation that he's going to have a fifth child, a male child.
I don't know what kind of topics you're going into, but is
the... Tadkira, your books, the problem, all this is from your books.
Why speak about Palestine? Why is it that in your country, Saudi Arabia, Bangla, Syria, all of these Muslim countries, why are they not protecting and condemning the attacks that is happening in Palestine?
Okay.
Tell me.
Do you want me to answer?
Yeah.
Okay, these Qadianis, where did I went? To Haifa, which is occupied.
You're speaking about us, I'm speaking about
you. I'm just telling you because we're not helping.
Also.
You see, we don't help the Palestinians.
Because you don't know what we believe.
Okay, we don't help the Palestinians.
Why are they not condemning it?
You just accused us,
just
yeah?
Why are they not condemning it?
Okay, no problem. So, see, you
publicly,
the people.
Publicly all over the news.
Okay,
why?
But you help Palestinians, yeah?
We are trying to help them, yes.
Okay, no problem.
We've got humanitarian
Let me tell the people
charity.
What you do.
We have our own charity organization.
Okay, I know. Not only in... Listen. They have charities. Not only in... They have them in Gambia. They have them in South America. What they do?
They go...
What they do? Listen to this. They go to these countries where ignorance is absolutely thriving. And then what they do?
We go to these people that no one
is helping. Yeah, I know what you do to them.
I know very well what you do to them. No one comes over
they
to
go,
them helps them.
They build hospital,
no
a hospital,
water,
yeah,
no
normal
them
hospital.
No one gives them any resources.
A school. And then what they say to them? La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. They don't go and tell them we are Qadianis, because people will throw stones at them.
No,
so they go. They say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Once they get the people, they start giving them money. Like what they did in Canada.
No, they took
all the Syrians. It's on TV. Are you a fool?
Look what happened.
Muhammad, please. Masroor.
Burkina Faso.
Muhammad, Masroor.
Terrorists came into Islam and the mosque and started attacking them.
Muhammad, Masroor.
They killed 8-9 people.
Because you're spreading mischief. People don't like mischief. They don't like lies.
You still have the right to go and kill someone just because they're spreading.
No.
Their
listen. We don't condone killing people.
So what? No, you are. That's what you're doing. You're saying because they went into a
I said no.
Okay.
I said
no. Zubillah. That's what you're saying.
Muhammad, I said because they said maybe they propagating mischief and the people didn't like it when they heard a Messiah and that maybe that. But personally,
you have the right to go kill someone in the mosque.
Muhammad, don't put words into my mouth, please.
When did Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam ever say, okay,
you Muhammad,
right
your people went and slaughtered people in Iraq for the British Raj. You slaughtered. In Al Fadl, I gave you. Muhammad, 1923, August 1923, your magazine.
Okay, you gave us a reference.
Yeah, I just gave you a reference, but you're not taking these references.
No, it's recorded, so we'll get the reference.
But you know what? Your murabbis will know, and they know it very well.
Yeah, they'll answer.
And anyway, so in lately about a month ago, your Masroor, what he did, your Masroor, it's not my Khalifa.
It's not my Khalifa.
A Khalifa without country, a Khalifa that has got a British passport.
You cannot stop a Khalifa. You cannot.
La ilaha illallah. Okay, I want to follow this Khalifa. What is your country? What is your country, Yalla?
It's British. So
the Messiah, Yalla, what is your country?
So the Messiah, he's going to have...
what is your country?
Four corners of the earth.
Okay, well, okay. So four world, corners of the earth.
The whole world.
Okay, well, I want to follow Ahmadiyya and yes. I want to follow the Khalifa and I want to give him allegiance.
Yes.
Show me the country. I don't want to be in Britain.
So
I'm going to renounce to the passport and I'll follow your Khalifa, Yalla.
So you have the 10 conditions of bad.
What are the 10 conditions?
The 10 conditions. You have to accept the 10 conditions.
Disbelieve in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Well, you have to, because Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says la nabiyya ba'di, and he says there is a prophet. So what are the 10 conditions? You should know them by heart, Muhammad. Muhammad, you should do your homework before you come to talk to me. You know.
Okay, number one.
Mm-hmm.
10 condition of bad is number one that till the last day of his life he shall abstain from shirk, associating any partners with Allah.
Okay.
Number two, that he shall keep away from falsehood, cruelty, adultery, dishonesty, disorder, rebellion, and every kind of evil.
Okay.
Number three.
Brother, catch this for me. Just give me a second. And this, please.
Five times daily.
Okay, yeah.
So, salat five times.
Yeah.
Number four. He shall not inflict injury on any of Allah's creatures.
Okay, even birds, yeah? Even birds. So I can't eat. I can't eat chicken.
That he would bear.
I just asked you, Muhammad.
For the sake of Allah. Number six. That
so
he
no chicken,
not
no lamb, nothing.
Warground customs and guard against evil inclinations. Number seven. That he shall discard pride, conscience, live in humanity and meekness.
Okay.
Number eight. That he shall hold his faith, dignity, and the welfare of Islam.
Okay.
Dearer than his own life.
Okay.
Wealth and children.
All right. Sabi, that's the 10, yeah?
No.
Okay.
Number
what? Number 9?
Number 8. Number 8.
Okay, number 9.
Number 9. That he shall have sympathy for all of God's creatures.
Okay.
And devote his talent to their welfare.
All right.
Number 10. That he shall establish brotherhood with me, the Messiah.
Okay.
Obey me in all good things and firmly adhere to these rules until the last breath of his life.
No problem. So these are the 10 commandments.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
No problem.
Of bad.
Okay.
So what you do is when you fill the form of bad, you are putting allegiance to the Messiah.
To the Messiah, not
and
to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No, but you said to the Messiah.
The Messiah is from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
No, but you said to the Messiah.
Yes.
You see, let me tell you.
The Messiah.
When I ask people to Islam, I say, Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. That's it. Salah, Zakah, which you didn't mention in there. Siyam.
Yes, I did.
Which? No, you didn't say Zakah.
Money, wealth.
Yeah, listen, Siyam, fasting. And guess what? And Hajj. Where Hajj? Where? Not to Qadian. Not to Qadian.
These are the five pillars of Islam.
Have you ever done Hajj?
No,
did Mirza Ghulam do Hajj? Did Mirza Ghulam do Hajj?
I don't know.
He never did it.
They wanted to kill him.
سبحان الله العظيم.
محمد, this is the problem with you.
Was Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم not forbidden to go to Makkah and do
No, he did. He did Hajj. He did Umrah. He did four Umrahs.
But was there no time when the people of Saudi Arabia they wanted to kill him?
No, no, no. Muhammad.
Kill Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Muhammad.
And stopped him from going Hajj.
Muhammad.
There was.
Hajj, he did Hajj once because
yes,
Hajj.
But then after, was he not forbidden? Was he not?
What do you mean after? What do you mean after? After is the conquer of Mecca.
Yes, when they conquered Mecca, the disbelievers.
When was Mecca conquered, Muhammad?
I don't know about history.
So don't say after and that, Muhammad. When you don't know something, Muhammad, listen to me. A prophet of Allah, fears nobody and seeks nobody protection because Allah Jalla wa Ala, Wallahu ya'simuka min al-nas.
Same with Mr. Ghulam Ahmad.
Listen.
Same thing.
Muhammad.
He always says,
Do you realize, under the protection of the British Raj? Is that it?
Well, this is the, you're talking about what's happening on the earth and the nature. And
what was it? You know what, Muhammad, go and learn and then we can talk, yeah? But I'll tell you what, Muhammad, Jazakallah khair. But I tell you what, Muhammad, listen to me. I invite you to leave this kufr and come. Listen, Muhammad, and come and do your shahada. We'll teach you. Wallahi al-Azim, I do not want you or any of these Qadiani laymen. You see these missionaries like Ahmed, Ibrahim, Tamim Abu, the one that said, إِذَا الْعُشَارُ عُطِّلَتْ مَشِي إِذَا الْعِشَارُ عُطِّلَتْ إِذَا الْعُشَارُ عُطِّلَتْ.
I invite you to Islam and Madiyah. I invite you
what have you got? What have you got for me that I haven't got in Islam? Come, yalla. I'll become a Qadiani straight away. Give me something that I don't find in Islam. Give me something.
Khalifa. Unity.
Khalifa, what is your Khalifa? Where is your Khalifa? In Canada. In Canada.
Sitting in the palace.
Yeah, in Canada. In Canada. Well, in Canada. Is Canada Qadian?
Is it good to mock a Khalifa?
Is it Qadian?
It's not good to mock a
Khalifa. He can't recite Quran, subhanAllah.
He knows how to recite.
Wallahi, he can't.
And no one else.
He can't recite Quran. Does he lead? Does he lead prayers? Does he do Jum'a?
Yes, he leads the Jum'a. He leads the five prayers as well. He leads all the five prayers.
Muhammad. Wallahi,
he knows the Quran.
This is out of pity for you.
He knows the Quran more than you.
Muhammad.
He knows the Quran more than anyone.
Oh, Muhammad. I'm sure he does. Do you want me to say one of your revelations? You know,
no, you keep speaking about
Wallahi, no, Mirza Ghulam,
Palestine.
Mirza Ghulam,
Let's
Mirza Ghulam, you know what he said? He said, Innani ma, the Allah Jalla wa Ala, listen to these people. Allah Jalla wa Ala said, Innani ma'a Rasul, ukhti'u.
Which one?
Ukhti'u wa usib. I am with the Prophet, I get it right, and I get it wrong. This is about Allah Jalla wa Ala. And then he said, Ilay, lima shabaqtani. My God, why did you forsake me? Yeah, from the Bible. This is, Yalla. Muhammad, learn. Wallahi al-Azim, we want good for you. Wallahi al-Azim. Come to Islam, Muhammad. Wallahi. Because we don't want you to go to hell. Wallahi, Muhammad. I'm talking to you from, you're a nice kid, you know? You are like my son. So Wallahi, look after yourself, Muhammad. This is, subhanAllah. You know, these people are misguided. But it's not, the problem is not theirs. The problem is their murabbis, their missionaries. They lie to them. You know, sometimes we look for references in their library, and guess what? You'll never find it where it is. But alhamdulillah, the Khatm al-Nubuwah in Pakistan, in India, and in all Asia, the brothers, jazahumullahu khair, from the time of Mulana Tana, from the time of Tanaullah, he started fighting that imposter, and alhamdulillah, it went far, and we have got their copies, the early copies. So that's how we know these things. The problem is that these people don't read. These laymen, they don't read. And they are a sect. And what you know about a sect? A sect is very difficult once you are inside to come outside. Your family gets threatened. And you will lose your money, you will lose your life, you will lose everything. So that's why they are scared. That's why when you speak to the layman Qadiani, be nice to them. Because wallahi, they do not know. But the murabbis and the missionaries have no pity on them.
I got a question.
We need to make dua for them as well.
Excuse
me. It's my turn, yeah. Why does murabbis don't dare to debate Muslims?
Well, they started. But the problem here is...
Those people are from that Ahmadi Kanan, like
Tani...
Qadiani?
Yeah. They come.
I said Ahmadi.
Listen, they are the same.
They said Ahmadi to fool Muslims. Something to do with Prophet Muhammad.
No, brother. No, they say Ahmadi. They say Ahmadi because his name is Mirza Ghulam Ahmad.
I know.
So that's why they say...
I know his name is Ghulam Ahmad, but you use it just for Muslims. It has something to do with Prophet Muhammad, whose name is Ahmad.
They say...
Qadiani.
So look. It doesn't matter. But if you go to da'wahwise.com, every Saturday, we debate them every Saturday. But the problem with them,
the heads.
Even we had their head, Tamim Abu Daqqa, who couldn't even recite Quran. إذا العشار عطلت, he said, إذا العشار لا تتركنا, he said, لا تتركنا القلاص. And Subhanallah. But all they want to debate about is the issue of Isa is not dead, Isa is alive. But the problem, the Quran, the lugha, the lexicon, everything is against them. It doesn't give them. So we ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to guide them, to protect them, and bring them to the haq. They have grown up since they know nothing but this. And the murabbis, they kind of brainwash them. They brainwash them. They say to them, be careful of the Muslims. Which is us. Be careful of the Muslims. Don't listen to them. If you go to their mosque, they will kill you. They will do this. So may Allah Jalla wa Ala make it easy for all of us and help our brothers and sisters in Gaza. May Allah Jalla wa Ala protect them. May Allah Jalla wa Ala bring them victorious. May Allah Jalla wa Ala unite their words. May Allah Jalla wa Ala take away their enemy. May Allah Jalla wa Ala throw fear in their hearts. May Allah Jalla wa Ala, whatever evil they plot, to be against them. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, wa jazakumullahu khayran.